non-stop snowstorm. Pirelli candle girls wrestling in body lotion. My head swimming with poetry and pro-tree. Excuse me one moment whilst I powder my nose. In my bag, in my good things, as bad as roses can be. We gave up sleep at the age of 17. My world's getting bigger as my eyesight gets worse. I can't see the lines on my idiot board. What about love? I don't let that stuff in my hands. This is the glamorous life, there's no time for fooling around. Lord have mercy, I know what I'm doing. I don't need an alibi, I need a fire escape.
Want to take a few minutes of your time this afternoon to introduce you to a few people and have them talk with you to try and make your life at Grimsby this year a little more pleasant. Begin by addressing my comments primarily to those people who are in grade 9. And if you're not in grade 9, please bear with me while you go through this. A couple of hints for those of you who have come into high school for the first time. This is a change for you, whether you realize it yet or not. The first problem that you're going to have to contend with is the transition from grade 8 to grade 9. The environment of a secondary school is not the same as that of an elementary school. Part of the problem that makes this transition difficult is your age. Think back 8 years ago, in grade 1 or kindergarten, and think of the kind of person you were, and remember that far back. You know you've changed. You say, oh yeah. During that period of time. This time of your life can be one of the happiest times of your life. It can be one of the worst times. That's really up to you. That's a decision that you have to make.
I'm going to say, hey, we want some hot dogs.
I think it's really great that the grade 13s are supporting the grade 9s. Oh, it's good, and that's it.
Been in the school overall, how have you found this year?
I've been extremely happy with it. The council, I think we've worked together as a team this year, and we've accomplished a lot of things. And not only that, but I think that the school spirit overall is up, and we've had a lot of fun, and I think that the students have had a good year.
To tell you the truth, I didn't like it at all. It was a very hard, grueling year, and it's going to be really hard for the exams. What about you?
Yeah, the exams are going to be real tough. Deb, come on.
How did you find this year?
As long as last year was.
What?
As long as last year was.
Fine. Besides, I have white paint all over my shirt.
Ash, I think that this year, I guess any other year on student council, what you end up having is a core group of people that do a lot of the work, and then there's the other people that that don't pull their weight as much. And this year I feel that everyone has carried their weight and everyone has put their best effort into it.
We've experienced some good times. But if you elect me as social convener, I will guarantee that each and every one of you guys will experience the year of your life.
I know what you're thinking. Why should we vote for Sandy? Well, I think I will do a grand job doing this, okay?
Hi, my name is Jonathan Culp. I am the position of senior board of the pledge. I can draw well in respects to advertising. I demand the dog.
Even been better than previous years, because instead of having five people doing all the work, you've got the entire council of 20 doing the work, and it's made the load easier for all of us, and it's made it more enjoyable for all of us, and I think that really is a big plus, certainly from last year.
Okay. I don't know, like it would have been.
I was really proud with a lot of the things that we've done. I just wish we could have had more assemblies, actually. I know that that's something that the students like, and I think it's something they're going to work on.
I joined away to a party, and they ended up killing their girlfriend. The cripple has broken my life. It's a tough break.
Most memorable experience at this high school?
My most memorable experience. Oh my gosh. I've got to think about that one. Probably the day my desk was stolen.
Expand on that.
I had warned Bob Krause not to steal my desk for several months. And April Fool's Day, I walked in and my desk was gone. And there were a couple of grade 13s in there, and my first words, am I allowed to swear on this program?
Yeah, yeah.
As I stepped into the desk, I said, oh shit, and turned around on my heel and walked out, and I was as red as Squid's sweater there.
Let's go to fatigué de la chose comme ça. Tout son stylo, son manger.
What subject do you like the most?
Calculus.
Yeah.
I have to say, yeah, yeah. Because Mr. Hayhurst is a riot. Mm-hmm. And he's good at teaching, yeah.
What?
About.
Yeah.
Music.
English.
Music.
English. Okay, fine. Music's the best.
Drama. What? You can bag out or
it's just an interesting subject, I feel. It's very educational, and I like it a lot. It enhances my inner self, I believe, honestly.
Okay, what subject do you like the least?
That would have to be geography with Mr. Laird.
Mr. Laird! He's our hero! Mr. Laird's our hero.
So funny.
Numero 2, attention.
3. Allô, agence d'emploi Passepartout.
Bonjour, je m'appelle Henri Latour, je cherche un emploi.
Très bien, monsieur. Quelle est votre occupation?
Je suis programmeur.
Où est-ce que vous avez déjà travaillé?
Je n'ai pas encore d'expérience. J'ai fini mes cours au mois de juin. Ce sera mon premier poste.
Ah oui. Quel est votre numéro de téléphone?
C'est le 875-3227. Et j'ai mon permis de conduire. Merci bien.
De rien, monsieur. Au revoir.
And scholars take us back to that as the source of our English drama.
I think that you might be upset. Anyway, I think the job.
So.
A times.
A plus brackets. N minus 1. Times C.
Okay. And what is that? Is that really the sum?
What is this? One of the
What does that represent? That is the formula we have talked about. David? Term of? Right. I didn't hear you.
San Juan is a town. There is another little hint.
Great. Jody Petch, Ron McPherson, John McDonald, Jennifer Stallwood, Stephen Reel, Crystal Sheldrick, Derek Cartledge, Melissa Quinn, Sandra Giesbrecht, Derek Irwin, Jeff Lacoste, Gord Wiggins, Brian Wilson, Terry Lounsberg, Jason Sokolowski, Ben Kane, Tom German, Mike Wilson, Annette Applin, Carl Matheson.
About the band, we've had several nice things happen this year. Most of you are aware, of course, of the efforts of Jennifer Applerink and music, the original music called Les Miserables. Pleasure today to introduce most of you. I don't think most of you had the opportunity to hear the work by Alfred Mitchell, a contemporary work with his contemporary ensemble. They will do a couple of works for you later on.
Thank you.
times. I find being a woman in the workforce is a bit of a problem. And being a teenager, it's hard to get service in stores when you want to buy something expensive because they don't think you have any money. Which I don't, but I mean, that's not their concern, right?
People bugging me about being short.
Yeah, I get
that. Wait till grade 12.
Any particular good insults?
Oh, gee, there's been so much.
Mr. Wallace. He discriminated against the girls once, and half the girls in that class walked out. And I sat there and took it. And I don't think that should be allowed in school. Because he said that cleaning desks with cleaner is a woman's job. I think not. Men should do that kind of job.
Getting white paint all over my black shirt when I have to go to a job interview.
I'm just nervous. I got this my throat. I got a hem. But then it's been going on since last night. My throat is like itching, sort of. Oh man, get away.
Sitting in that,
feels nice,
right?
Yeah, look at that.
You gotta come up with me after I'm done. Go!
Look at the size of the thing they put in there. It's huge. Zoom in on this, man. Zoom in on this. This is a big mother of a needle. Zoom in on that. This hurts.
The high school program for sports is a little different than the town or elementary school. It's a lot more competitive. It's a lot more interesting. You have a better time, meet a lot more people. You're playing against people with a greater level of skill, so therefore you become better. There's so many sports. You gotta enjoy one. If you're not athletic, you can become athletic.
Or else.
He ain't never been against no fish.
In here, folks.
Time.
I got a call from Tony Rose. The FBI was tapping my telephone. I never live alone. I never walk alone. My posse's always ready and waiting in my zone. Although I live the life that I'm a resident, but I've been knowing the scheme that I'm the president. Tapping my phone. Who's screwed the views instead of who's the doing hard? To the bone, the bone, the bone. Full grown, consider me stone. Once again, and I say it for you to know, the truth is always ready. I am Geronimo, your CIA. You see, I ain't kidding. Both K and X, they got rid of both. A story untold, truth but unknown. Professor Griff knows.
Yo, I ain't no toast.
And not the bragging, I'm boasting. And plus, it ain't no secret why the tap on my phone. And though I can't keep it a secret, so I decided to keep it, yo. And yes, it waves a turn. I say it once again.
Taken it yet?
I don't know. Don't tell me they have
them. It's pretty disorganized, eh?
Jeez, fuck.
They just don't know what's going on.
Yeah, that's
I thought they didn't even
dump
anybody. They just see each other.
In the junior math contest,
Pleased to announce that out of the 31 schools in Niagara Peninsula that took part, we were second overall.
This year we started the Camera Club, and the first year was a separate organization.
So these guys had sort of an endurance test and hung right in there.
This year the yearbook is entitled The Best of the Last. This year we at GSS solved the world problems.
We started with a new philosophy as using the newspaper as a forum for school events and talent. The newspaper satisfied and showcased the work of the students rather than that of the editors.
To say, if you have any articles, hand them in like by Friday.
Okay.
And then we can go through them all this weekend, maybe get stuff typed.
Two bundles now.
Really?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Two bundles of these. Fergie's been selling like hell. Mr. Evans, 50 cents.
What a lovely cow.
Smoky area, go point it.
No, 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 no. I'm not supposed to be in front of the camera.
It's so smoky, it's smoky.
Line 16, Mr. Gerson.
They'll come out of those damn rockets, and I'll bet the first thing they'll do is stick a flag up in my moon. And I'll say, what are you doing? They'll probably say, well, you know about gravity, don't you? Because you live on the moon, don't you? And I'll say, well, you know, I don't. And they'll say, hear that, gang? He doesn't even know about gravity. Been on this moon all the time, and he doesn't even know about gravity. I'm sure they'll be quite nice about it and say stuff like, oh, but don't you dress neatly? But, you know, you're just a bunch of scientists anyway. No heart.
Be there! There's gonna be me and four other killers ready to demolish, destroy, and decimate.
I was sitting there in shop class, carefully molding my birdhouse into its final form when Carrie Sired entered the shop class, lanced the orange at me, I caught it with left hand and said, I'm gonna keep this object for the rest of my life.
There's a little bit of when you're early in the morning and the fish won't bite. That's on my mind.
In Macbeth, the king's horses ate each other. I just thought that was interesting.
Yeah.
That was an interesting part of the year, I think.
I thought Macbeth
sucked. So did I, but the king's horses ate each other.
What? Wait a minute, read that part?
Yeah, when he killed Duncan, Duncan's horses ate each other. They broke out of the stables and ate each other.
Oh, look at them running. Oh, look.
Go,
at them
Mark!
I don't think I could run that fast, but maybe I could. However, not today.
Well, they're not very good at relay. Like, the guys are waiting there for their batons. They're supposed to be running when they get the batons.
I was in a relay, and we got first.
Go, Matt! Go!
Well, one day they
were. May I have your attention, please? Today is November the 11th, Remembrance Day, 1988. 2 years ago at this time, I talked to you about past wars in the century and the very heavy destruction and loss of life that occurred as a result of those wars. Last year when I talked to you, I talked to you about the possibility of war in the future and the very real destruction, destruction beyond our imagination, that would occur if we got involved in major warfare again. This year, in looking for a different approach, I came across an article written by a Canadian journalist, Kenneth Bagnall, as well as a poem written by a Canadian youngster. And I'd like to have both of those read to you today. One day, just about a quarter of a century ago, I was alone in a city in Europe on a Sunday. I went by bus to the edge of the city, where beyond a wide boulevard sheltered with great oaks, I came upon a cemetery, a stretching field of green. There were no visitors that day, but there was a handful of women, elderly, stooped and purposeful, like the ones I had seen polishing and cleaning in European churches, clipping, raking, watering. I wandered down a path to where one of them, a dark woman with a lined, weathered face and a tight kerchief, was clearing the grass at the base of one of the stones. We nodded. But it was what was on the stone beside her that had stayed with me the most strongly, engraved in memory as on the stones itself. It gave the name of the man buried there, his military number, and the years of his birth and death. His name was David McLeod. He was 18. I often find myself thinking in random moments of that afternoon in the almost empty cemetery. It remains vivid, I believe, because by then I was in my 30s, suddenly able to see that so many of the soldiers, airmen, and sailors who died when I was a child during the war were almost children themselves. Lest we forget, would you please now stand in silence.
Mr. Mitchison,
as a person overall, he was great.
I think
great
he's the principal. Best principal we've had.
Oh, yeah. Really down-to-earth guy.
Good job.
Yep.
As I hate him.
I don't care if you tell him or not. I hate him.
Is he leaving?
Yeah.
Yes.
Did you know that?
No, I didn't. I wasn't at the assembly.
I don't have anything against him.
He's an okay guy. At least we saw him around the school sometimes. Other than Mr. Irwin, who hid in his office every day.
He's an excellent guy. He's so laid back and so relaxed, and he was always willing to do what was best for the students, and he was always on our side. That's the big thing. And not only that, but he's was always so easygoing about things. He never went off his rocker kind of thing, unlike other faculty members. And
fine. I thought he was a good principal, actually, because even though he's like super conservative and just sort of shakes his head at people, he's a nice man, and I guess it's not his fault he has to be a principal.
Mrs. Lazenby to the main office, please. Mrs. Lazenby.
The drama department has done a number of things of which I'm extremely proud, and I'm just going to say thank you to a number of people that made that all possible. However, I'd like to talk for a second about some of the things that we've done this year with what could be called the drama club, I guess. Two wonderful and outstanding drama festival productions.
It is.
Saxophone music, from which Britt Walker was awarded the best actor at the regional level, or at the district level, sorry.
Let me explain something. Two people living together.
Like you and me?
Could be like you and me. Could be like a mother and a father. Now, these two people, one's gotta lead, one's gotta follow, right?
Sure.
Okay. The father, the man, he leads.
He works, brings home the money, takes care of things. The mother watches him. She tells him how he's doing. Except for him, she couldn't live. And that's very important.
Same with you and me, okay? But you can never have two fathers living together, or two mothers. Too much leading on one side, too much watching on the other. See, it's the same with you and me. One leader, one follower.
You don't want me to play the saxophone anymore.
Emil, that's not the point. The point is, I don't want you out there like that no more, man. When you could be killed for just a few lousy bucks. Not when I have the ability and the training to bring in $25 an hour. You want to play? Play for me. Just not an hour, we'll both be out on the sidewalk. And don't worry. Be patient. I got us a place to stay today, man. And that's something.
It's not enough.
Did you say something?
It's not enough.
Joyride, which was considered the outstanding production at that level. I would also like to say that Joyride went on to the regional level and got an honorable mention, which placed it among the top 15 plays, according to the adjudicator, out of nearly 300 plays that started in the province.
Margie?
Mm-hmm.
Nothing. Sorry. Margie, I really, really find this an embarrassing question. Well, I have to go to the washroom, and I was just wondering, you know, since you've been here for a while, I was just wondering if... I couldn't. No, I mean, I really couldn't. You do?
Uh-huh.
This?
Mm-hmm.
Well, turn around. Right around.
Then we got to the, I guess, larger show, larger by numbers, larger by a lot of ways, Les Miserables.
Can shoes. I said,
stress situations are often momentary, but they belong to really the child and damage it. And if those stress points can be relaxed, and if we had more of those...
You don't mind if I color this, do you?
Really,
people
help.
No, it's not that.
Like 12 hours? What are you gonna do to celebrate?
I'm gonna get laced with Trish over there.
I'm going to go home, watch the Jetsons.
No, you're gonna get started right on next semester's work.
Yes, I went to my teacher and I asked them for all the work.
Me
and I'm
too.
Now studying, getting ahead on my homework. And just the personal satisfaction of doing what a good student
exactly.
should do makes me feel good.
Exactly.
Thank you.
There has been some controversy recently over something called hush hush day.
I think this year that the graduating committee did a fantastic job in concealing where the grade 13s were going, and I think that was the nicest thing, whereas the younger students didn't know where we were going.
I want to commend Doug Muir for his defense of our reputation.
This is a reply to an article which was appeared in The Independent regarding our hush hush day. I must commend you on your excellent image-shattering and character-destroying article that appeared in the May 24th issue of the Grimsby Independent. You have surely given Grimsby a terrible opinion of us kids here at GSS. The article is fantastically one-sided and depicts what you believe to be a true picture of our one day of drug-smoking, beer-drinking, blood-bashing, beach-partying. I'm glad you realize that GSS is merely an institution full of wasted, useless lumps of flesh. Hush Hush Day is definitely not what you think. Naturally, everyone is secretive in order to avoid persecution from school officials and to avoid tipping off the police intelligence network. The graduating class fully understands the worries and complaints of the teachers and staff. The grade 13s don't want the younger grades to go at all. We try to avoid letting them know because we understand the increased risk they have. Nothing against them personally, but they'll have their day. It is immature to believe that there have been no accidents only because of luck. It is hard to have respect for elders who judge the younger generation based on several unrelated reports. Hush Hush Day is a day when a group of friends, together for one of the last times after 5 years, and who have worked very hard, are simply having one good party. Sympathy we don't want. Understanding is adequate. Amir.
Yesterday is over. Let's go on giving our students the recognition they deserve. Thank you. Well, I just wanted to say that this has been the best 5 years. Great demo, great demo, great demo is alive. But after that, it has gotten to be great. In the last 2 years, I have really thoroughly enjoyed it. I've enjoyed the students. I've enjoyed working with the council and the teachers. And I found everybody to be so cooperative. And it's just been the ultimate years. It's so hard to explain, actually, how I feel about it. It's just, I'm going to be so sad when I leave. I'm going to go on to university, and I was just thinking about it the other night. I was thinking, like, God, I'm going to be going on university, and half the people I'm not going to see again. I was just really getting a bit nervous about it, and I'm going to miss everyone, and I'm going to miss the school. But I'll...
No, except that, I don't know, it's going to be a bad school at times, and I hope to have a great year next year.
No.
Just that everyone should have a really good summer. And don't get sunburned because it's skin cancer. And remember not to use aerosol products because you'll put holes in the ozone layer and I'll be really pissed off. I'm so excited!
Yeah, I've got more pain in my shirt. And I can't say no to people when they ask me for a favor. And therefore I end up losing myself.
You people are incredible. You picked that up so fast. We're gonna do it one more time. Turn the tape off!